Ernest Dickerson was trying to push this movie in the early 80s, they improvised the script to update it to more 90s terms. I wonder if the movie still was
because
about
juice.
Because
it was juice. So old, they were like, say, Jack.
Say, sucker.
Another question that we had as we were watching this movie over in preparation for our fan theory that we have on juice, it's that... What was the whole DJ angle anyway? And the best I could come up with was that it was very trendy at the time. You know, it was a very it and in thing with hip hop, and it would be appealing to the target market for this film.
I think in the mid 90s, in the mid 80s, it was, hey, hip hop is dance, right? So you had the dance movies and stuff, basically. And then later on, in the 90s, it's saying we can't really necessarily repeat that, and maybe it's not a strictly rapper movie. In Juice, hey, we need to have hip hop. We gonna get hip hop folks to go and support this movie. Put a rapper in there who's on the come ups, and make the star a DJ who's basically doing hip hop. And it was very trendy to just try to throw some hip hop into some stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. Cause if it was ever like, let's say if hopefully never, but if they chose to update this movie and do a, you know, new version of Juice, then, what would Q's, I don't know, his talent be like, would he be a rapper or
a producer?
Would he be making beats? You know, what would he be doing? Because, you know, in 2022, he can't be, you know, scratching it out.
a DJ contest. When is the last time you really had that as something big?
Yeah, like, probably in 1992. I mean, so that, you know, but like, could the movie have survived without him being a DJ? Like, yeah, it helped to be an alibi when they do the robbery, but...
Yeah, where else?
Something else
this...
could have been. He could have been like, I was singing in my church, in my church choir or whatever.
Yeah, it's
could
very...
have been anything.
I don't know why what that served in the movie, him being a DJ.
Mm. Yeah.
Because even in the end, he doesn't get the glory from being a DJ. It's just kind of like, oh yeah, he was trying to be a DJ, and now in the end, you got the juice by.
You like, got the juice.
You didn't finish it out. Like, what happened?
Finished off your friend. Now you got the juice. Okay, another.
He could have at least sold a mixtape at the end and been like, where's your mixtape? Boom, boom, like Hustle and Flow.
Yeah, that's true. But this was not that for sure. I just want to ask the folks, and I'm sure we have some people from New York or at least have a East Coast type of background. Did y'all ever use the word juice? Because I feel like they were trying to make a slang term that was gonna stick.
Yeah.
And, being from Chicago, juice did not, like, we were not saying, we made fun of that term after this movie. It was like, you got the juice, you know, because it was so absurd, even so, in our youth.
Okay. I don't know which came first, if they reworked the title, but Ernest Dickerson was trying to push this movie in the early 80s.
That's the guy who wrote and made the movie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And Omar Epps talked about how they updated it in the early 90s because it was so old that they basically improvised the script to update it to more 90s terms. I wonder if the movie still was
because
about
juice.
Because
it was juice. So old, they were like, say, Jack.
Say, sucker.
We basically freestyled the whole film. So the dialogue was like, you better come here, Jive Turkey.
I wonder if he still had that working title of Juice in the 80s, and then that didn't get translated to whatever 90s terms they may have been getting used. Yeah.
But I don't even know if they were using juice as something, and again, they emphasized, because we did, okay, and this is another thing, because everybody's always like, watch the deleted scenes, trust and believe, we watched all of this stuff and watched probably more interviews than you care to know about. One of the things they also impressed was how New York this movie needed to be. The actors needed to be from New York. Everybody had to be New York. It couldn't be that you were from someplace else. So everything was New York, actually.
Yeah.
And was it all in Brooklyn? Because did they even say, I feel like in that interview that we saw with Ernest Dickerson, he said that even it was within everything was filmed within a two or three block radius.
You know, the different boroughs of New York had different styles. You know, Brooklyn had a style. You know, the Bronx had a style. And Harlem had a style. It was essential that we made it feel like we were where we were. We actually shot in Harlem. Being true to Harlem was essential because I always wanted the film to be real, man.
It was not just that, but it was within that particular borough. And, so it wasn't just New York. It was the borough. And it was particular. Everything was particular to that. And each borough had their own style, et cetera, back then.
Yeah. And so maybe they just said juice in this borough.
Yeah. You know, I mean, it could.
Yeah. It could be.
Because, you know, and one thing, I don't know, this is just one thing that stands out to me about. Remember, we talked about the movie Baby Boy, but something that they said a lot in Baby Boy that I had never heard of, which, you know, Baby Boy was filmed in like California, Southern California, but they would always be like, please believe
he don't love that hoe.
They said that a whole lot. We were not saying that. I was like, why do they keep saying please believe? Like, that is not a bit of our vernacular where I'm from in the Midwest in Chicago. But okay. And I think it did kind of take off a little bit. But, you know, when you get to see films made from other places besides New York, because, you know, most of the influence of hip hop and everything we saw at that time, it was all based on New York.
Yeah, it's like the spreading of culture. You have the culture where you're from, which gonna be your language. Mm-hmm. And then once this goes out to other people in those tangent cultures, like Black Americans in the South or in the West or in the Midwest, then you start to take on some of that culture. And that's how, you know, that's what happens.
Yeah.
And so then you started saying juice.
I never said. We would just be like, I want the juice.
Oh, man.
You got the juice. But it was always said. We said it as a joke after seeing this movie. And it never entered our vernacular as far as like anything that would ever be serious. It was always in reference to this movie.
Please Believe did, probably.
I think Please Believe did. But you know what? Actually, going to college in the 90s, when I met a lot of people from California in college, they had their own, you know, language and words and slang that they were using. One of them that I had never heard was the word hella. They were saying hella. The people from
the
California, I don't know. The person I knew was from Compton. And she was always like, oh yeah, it's hella big. It's hella this. It's hella. Like everything was hella. And I was like, oh, okay. And then eventually, even though we were at a HBCU in the South, we started saying the word because, you know, she influenced our language. And then, you know, when I went back to Chicago and I'm saying hella here and there and they looking at me like that. But then it just, you know, that's how language works.
Yeah. That's how culture works.
Mm-hmm. So anyway, let us know what you think.
Why was Q a DJ and did they really have to put that element in the movie?
Right. Could the movie have survived? Could he have been something different? I mean, we know they needed the DJ angle for the cover for the robbery. But other than that, what was really the point? Or maybe it was just to hit home the hip-hop culture at the time. Let us know what you think.
Yeah, it could just be like, hey, they have people who just happen to be DJs, and that's his story. But did y'all use the term juice? Anybody out there, did y'all actually use the term juice like it was used in the movie Juice?
That's a really good question. And let us know, were you guys, spinning turntables? Any of you all DJs making music back then?
If you appreciate what we're doing here, I would like to let y'all know that we do have memberships, so you can sign up as a member on the channel.
That's right. And if you like this discussion about Juice, just know that we have a Juice fan theory dropping soon. And if you're watching this video at a later date, go and check out our fan theory on this movie, Juice.